Hello friends, myself R.D. Mahajan presenting my video on the topic Fourier series for even function. Let us solve the problem. Find the Fourier series for the function f of x is equal to 1 plus 2x by pi, range minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 0, and second value is 1 minus 2x by pi, 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi. And as the interval is minus pi to plus pi, we can check the function for even or odd, whether it is even or odd. For that, let us consider first function f1x as 1 plus 2x by pi, minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 0. Replacing x by minus x, we get f1 of minus x as 1 minus 2x by pi, minus pi less than or equal to minus x less than or equal to 0. Multiplying by minus sign, we get 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi. 0 to pi, original value is 1 minus 2x by pi, and we are getting the same value, 1 minus 2x by pi, after replacing it by minus x. And f2 of x is equal to 1 minus 2x by pi, range 0 less than or equal to x less than or equals to pi. Here also, replacing x by minus x, we get f2 of minus x is equals to 1 minus minus 2x in bracket minus 2x divided by pi, 0 less than or equal to x, 0 less than or equal to minus x less than or equals to pi. Minus minus it become plus, 1 plus 2x by pi. Multiplying by minus sign, we get minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equals to 0. Minus pi to 0, original value is 1 plus 2x by pi, and here we are getting the same value, and that is we get f of minus x as f of x, same function, and that's why function is an even function. And as it is even function, bn is 0, we require to find only a0 and an. A0 is given by 2 by L integral from 0 to L f of x dx. Here the value of L is pi, as it is minus L to L type, and therefore A0 is equals to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi, and in the range 0 to pi the value of that function is 1 minus 2x divided by pi, and its integration with respect to x, and therefore it is 2 by pi integrating this with respect to x, its integration is 1 minus 2x by pi whole square divided by 2. Into a is the coefficient of x, the coefficient of x is minus 2 by pi, and limits from 0 to pi, we get it is pi goes to numerator, therefore it is 2 by pi multiplied by pi divided by 4. Minus sign I will cancel by changing the limits. Therefore, upper limit becomes 0. When x is 0, we get 1. 1 square is 1. Minus lower limit. Lower limit as pi. Pi, pi get cancelled. 1 minus 2. And its square, we get pi pi get cancelled, it is 1 by 2 multiplied by, it is 1 minus, 1 minus 2 is minus 1, and minus 1 square is 1, and therefore 1 minus 1 is 0, we get the value of a0 as 0. An is given by 2 by L integration from 0 to L f of x cos of n pi x by L, and its integration with respect to x. Substituting the value of L and that function, we get a n as 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f x in that range is again 1 minus 2x by pi into cos n pi x by pi get cancelled, we get cos of nx only. And as it is integration of product of two terms of x, we have to apply integration by generalized part. This first term is algebraic, therefore we consider it as first term, and cos as trigonometric, we consider that as second term. And therefore, performing by that generalized part, we get 2 by pi as it is. First term, 1 minus 2x by pi, integration of cos is sine of nx divided by n, then minus, derivative of this term with respect to x, its derivative is minus 2 divided by pi, coefficient of x, and integration of sine, next integration of sine is minus cos nx divided by n square plus next derivative of this term is 0, we stop here and limit from 0 to pi. When we substitute upper limit for x as pi, it becomes sine n pi, and the value of sine n pi is 0, therefore that term becomes 0, minus 3 times minus, it is minus 2 divided by n square pi cos of n pi. The value of cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n minus lower limit when x is 0, sin 0 0 minus cos 0 1. Therefore, we get 2 by pi n square. From these two terms, we can take 2 by n square pi common. Therefore, it is 2 by pi multiplied by 2 by n square pi. Remaining terms are, here it is minus, it becomes plus 1. And here it is minus 1 raised to n. And as we are getting this term 1 minus 1 raised to n in the numerator, we are getting two different values. We require to find two different values depending upon the nature of the n. When it is n, minus 1 raised to 2, we get plus 1. Therefore, 1 minus 1, we get 0. Therefore, that value is 0 if n is even. And when n is odd, minus 1 raised to 1, we get minus 1. That minus and this minus, it become plus. 1 plus 1, 2. And 4 to the 8. Therefore, we get that value as 8 divided by n square pi square if n is odd. And as it exists for odd values only, we have to replace n by its general term 2n minus 1 while substituting it in that Fourier series result. Equation number 2. And the third coefficient, bn is equal to 0. As it is even function. Therefore, substituting all these values in that Fourier series and bn, we get the required Fourier series as f of x as it is having two values, we put fx as it is. A0 is 0, an is 8 upon n square pi square, and it exists for all values, and as it exists for all values, we replace it by its general term, n replaced by 2n minus 1. Therefore, it becomes 8 divided by 2n minus 1 whole square pi square cos of nx, in that also replacing n by 2n minus 1. Therefore, it becomes cos of 2n minus 1 times x as the required series, and bn is 0. And therefore, simplifying it, 8 by pi square we take outside, summation from 1 to infinity, 1 upon 2n minus 1 whole square into cos of 2n minus 1 times x as the required Fourier series. Containing a cosine terms only, as that function is an even function. In my next video, I will discuss next point of half range Fourier series. If you are watching my videos, please like and share it, as well as subscribe to my channel to get new updates on new videos. Thank you very much.